guys, this is Game Boy Luke here, and welcome back to Small Let's Play Pokemon Tournament. In the previous episode, it's been like 2 weeks since I played this game. Actually, it's probably a bit of an exaggeration, probably about a week now, because we were at PAX East last week. It's just over a week now, actually, now I think about it, because just before PAX East, we fixed everything with Shadow Mewtwo. Everything is now good with him, and we're currently, you know, ready to face the freaking Ferrum League and do the Chroma stuff. I'm honestly so scared. I have no idea how this is gonna go down. I'm very scared.
There's nothing wrong with dropping down to a lower league to catch a break here and there.
Honestly, I honestly don't disagree with you right there. I think honestly going back to one of these leagues and playing around probably a good idea. But here we are, the Chroma League.
It's been a bumpy road, but you finally made it. This is the top of the top.
The top of the top.
If you make it to the top here,
the top of the top of the top.
This year's Ferrum League champion.
Hell yes!
You're gonna have to face opponents like you've never seen before.
Okay.
But I think you've got what it takes.
Thank you. I can
for
do
starters,
it.
Battle your way through league.
It's time to do some league matches, and I'm. There's a Sceptile. There is a Sceptile. Oh, okay, I haven't played this game a great deal over the last few days. I played a little bit of PAX at the actual Pokemon booth, which was quite fun to do. I just need to channel my inner Lucario, okay? But we're in Diggersby, starting with Diggersby Land. So, you know, not everything's bad right now. It's me and you to the end, Lucario. Let's do this, brother.
Pokemon, do you want to tag for
who is the opponent? It's Blaziken, right? He leaves the ground a lot. Blaziken always jumps. I'm gonna zone you out. I'm gonna zone you out, bro. Yo, that's insane. That's right. Oh, wow. I'm gonna just keep throwing this move out because it's good. Have to wait for him to move there. That's not good. He grabbed me as well. Oh, I'm dead. That's so punishable. Extreme speed is so punishable. You have to be super careful. Ooh, I was getting ready to throw that down. The noises Blaziken makes is hilarious. Gotcha. Gotcha. I timed that perfectly. He punched me as soon as Force Palm came out, and it cut him off.
What
we're trying to do right here. Alright, Rotom. So we both have our synergy right now, so have to be careful. Yeah. Approach me now, bro. I almost countered right there, I want you to know. You can fly, it's so weird how you can fly like that. Ah, that's fine, that's easy. He grabbed me in the left. Damn, son. I need to be careful, because some of those counter moves can be grabbed out of. Gotcha, only just, bearing in mind. Come here. Step back. Okay, gotcha, that was nice, that was nice. Come on, jump off the ground, I dare you. Miss me. Ooh, wait, hold on! Jump! Oh, Rotom didn't get him. What you want to do? Is this how you want to play? I grab me again! Is that gonna kill me? Oh no, I'm good. I think I'm good. Oh, I have my synergy, why don't I use it? Let's go. That was sick. I approached him, he countered, I countered his counter. Counterception! Whew! That was good. That was a good match. These Chroma, I can already feel the tension. And the difficulty spike with the Chroma League, though, they're very, very scary, to say the least. They are very, very spooky, very scary. They know what they're doing. I just have to be so careful. I'm not sure how many losses I'm going to get through participating in this league in particular. But so we have 73 battles. We've lost 2 out of the whole amount that we've played, which is really good. I'd say that's pretty good. I think I've seen somebody play through this game and only lose like once, but I'll take 2.
All right then.
Okay, so Charizard, a very, very scary character. Get out of here, dude. Got you again. Oh, he was in the air. That's so sick. That was sick, to be honest. I don't know how I didn't get him, but. Gotcha, there we go. There we go. Alright, Rotom, get him. Yeah! So if you time that right, Rotom does it does indeed actually paralyze them after recovery. Uh-oh. That's a perfect punish. Again. Woo! That was close. That was close. The Bone Rush came in handy that last second. It's so long range. It's so long range. Okay. Gotcha. Alright. I'm out of here. Bye. Get out of here. I don't think so, Charizard. Did you see that? That was sick! That was sick. Oh my god, I just pulled off a sick move. Holy crap. Gotcha. Ooh. Wait, get down from there. Get down from there. Yeah. Gotcha, there he is. There it is. There it is. Oh wait, he's not dead? Now he is. Ooh. That was sick. Oh my god, did you see those counter cancels I did? Oh my goodness. I'm getting a real good feel for this game. Starting to get those parries and stuff going on. I'm very happy with that. Very happy with that. Also using trying to use Rotom to my advantage, like he was in the air, that I was almost able to combo off of it. Like a full-on blown combo. Cause if he'd fallen down and then I bone rushed into it, it would have been like me doing my X to start the combo, but Rotom would have been one that started that combo. It would've been sick. Okay, so Chandelure. I haven't played PK Chandelure enough. Everything I do, I need to, because Chandelure is a very interesting character. It has a grab from range. It has a crazy, ridiculous projectile move that I need to be super, super conscious of. I'm pretty sure that's Will-O-Wisp. That's the move. Jesus. Get down from there. Get down from there. Oof. Gotcha. The one thing I have seen about Chandelure's dash attack or dash in is that it's like it has quite good punishable frames. The punishable frames are right there, so like once you jumped in, I was just able to punish that. Okay, cool. Let's see. Damn, son. That's the combo. You just need a shield. That breaks counter? That's not fair. I'm dead. Gotcha. Oh! That was so close. Come here, Chandelure. I actually meant to do my synergy right there, not Rotom, but... Damn, son! Watch this. Last second. And got it. I want you to know, like, it holds on to your last single bit of synergy right to the very end. And then as soon as you stand up, if you just spam the synergy, you may as well just throw it out and see if you can get the last kill, so... And I did. It came in useful, I didn't expect it, because you're not out of synergy. But look at that. Doing well. This is good. I'm liking this a lot. Lucario's coming through for us right now, and I'm actually like trying to practice my parry stuff. You know what I mean? Like my counter cancels, just trying to get those down because they're really important. But I can't believe that Chandelure has a move that just breaks through counter. What's the point of having a counter if you can just break through it? That's ridiculous. All right, so Weavile, interesting character again. Let's see what I can do here. Haunted House. Get all revved up. I think Rotom's really good against Weavile too, because he likes to sit on the little platforms. Okay, get away from me. Yo, it throws him so far away. Come on. Nice. I think patience is a really important thing when it comes to this game. That was sick. Oh my god. What? 13? Perfect. Check me out. Oh my god. That was sick. That counter cancel was perfect. That was like a literal back. I played perfectly in that. You missed. What the heck? How did that not, like, I don't understand how that didn't finish the thing. Oh god. Okay. Damn it, she got me. Yeah, I came in with a bone rush. Too frisky, man. Bam. Too frisky. Alright. Damn, son. Bam, bam, bam. I should really do that, actually. Rotom needs to... I need to pull Rotom out just before they touch the ground. Because the trigger for Rotom is when they're in the air. And if they touch the ground, they don't have their invincibility frames anymore. So it's a really sneaky way of using Rotom. I have to remember that. You trigger Rotom just before they touch the ground. Sceptile. Okay, my... The worst... I don't know what I'm doing in Sceptile. Sceptile is so weird. Okay, Sceptile. Advisor fan. Okay. Stop telling me to relax. It makes me more anxious when you tell me that. Damn it. I'm gonna keep doing this, man. Oh my god. Jesus, I have no idea what to do against him. Oof, I wasn't accounting there as well. Oh, I thought I got that. Nah, I can't run in like that. Oh, damn, the wall combo. Okay, hold on. Wait, get this out. There it is. There we go. There we go. Go, okay, cool. Ooh, that was close. I was getting kinda scared there. One combo from that Sceptile and dead. Okay. Both have synergy right now. Ooh, okay. Oh god, no. Get down. Look, Jesus Christ! Okay. Let's get you out. Get up in the air. Custom combos. Alright, get this out. Bam. Okay, cool. Let's see if we can get my burst in. I'm not jumping then. That's fine. I'm just not gonna jump. Rotom, you've got Rotom. I'm just not gonna jump. How often do you see? I don't see them use support often either. So it's like kind of crazy that she brought out Rotom right there. But that's a good start to this Chroma League. If I do say so myself, that is a good start. I don't know if I've improved. I played a couple matches with Shino World or Shino Bean Trio, and I played a couple matches at PAX East. I don't know if I've improved since then. Your battles are fun, even just watching. Shino beat me. And I beat Mo and Nappy at PAX East. But like, I don't know. I don't think necessarily think I've improved. Maybe I just got lucky, or maybe I'm just taking it a little bit more slow. 16 ranks up. So basically, we've got to do a good like another like 20 odd matches. So I think what we can do is definitely go into it again. Why not? You know. We're only 14 minutes in anyway, so we'll make this a 30-minute episode. We have to get through the Promo League as fast as possible, so I'm down to do a few more of these. Weavile! Okay. Such skill. Much wow. I need to change my title and actually customize my character a little more, because we have money now. We have stacks of cash, and I just haven't spent any of it, so... Okay. And then my main thing is I want to prepare myself for the actual, like, final battle, if anything. I want to learn my counter cancels. I actually fucked it up there, but... There we go, that's what I like to see. Boom, look at that. Perfect! Look at me go, oh my god. Yeah. You don't take any damage when you counter. It's great. It's so great. Oh, hello. Ooh, okay. Don't think so. Oh, they can launch the synergy when you force palm them. I should probably bear that in mind for next time. That's kind of crazy. Right, dive straight into that. Gotcha. Nice, there we go. Come on, jump, I dare you. Jump, go on, jump. I forgot, once you switch from like field phase to normal phase, then Rotom disappears. It's a little bit disappointing. So they take you straight into like the thingy phase. Is that Rattata or Raticate in the background? When you switch to from field to dual phase, then they disappear. It sucks. So Machamp is another Pokemon that's very, very scary. I think the two Pokemon we lost to are Sceptile and Machamp, if I remember correctly. Look at Machamp. If to just look at him, we'd be scared. He's a freaking duck with muscles. He's ripped, and he has four arms. Lucario doesn't care, though. Lucario, literally, he doesn't care. He doesn't care. He bulked up straight away. He's throwing rocks at me. What is that? Nope. So I'm running like that again. Ah, there we go, cool. Can I grab me? Nope. Gonna walk in real slow like that, huh? Get up there. Perfect! Again! Come at me, bro!
That battle was awesome.
Thank you.
Can I expect round two?
Sick. Alright, let's go. Yeah. Oopsie. Ugh. Oh, I should have charged it more. Bruh. Nice. Did I get him? Nah. Boom, okay, wait. I didn't even get to use my synergy! I tried so hard. I'm gonna use my synergy to finish him up, but it's fine. I wanna get 5 stars in each of these. Is it possible? Has anyone ever done that? Played a pretty much perfect thing. Or according to the rating system, and actually got full 5 stars. I would love to know. Let's battle. You can't beat me, though. Famous last words and all that. You can't beat me, though. I'm sure. God of War, battle celebrity. All right. Well, you've got a pretty big head. How did you get through the door? Jeez. Teletown. This music's great. What? I still think that guy in the background there. Is wearing a freaking, looks like a Charmander hat. A Zangoose in the background. Why is Pinsir playing in the leaves? He's the last Pokemon you'd expect to be playing in the leaves. Okay. Your mind went straight through. What has she done there? What is that? Oh my god. Nope. Nope. Stop right there. Did I do it right? No. Okay. Espeon heals her up slightly. Ooh, alright. Damn. Okay. Holy crap, dude! I can't counter cancel now for some reason. There we go. Jesus Christ. Jesus. God of War is scary, dude. Oh my God. She got me. Okay, okay. God of War is very scary. She's so weird. Like, I don't know. I've never really played against God of War in this and have her act like this before. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. Yo, she just approached me like crazy. Oh my God. Nice. Gotcha. Woo! Wait. There we go. I'll take that. Get down from there. Okay. Woo! Okay, we have our burst. She doesn't. That's all that matters right now. That's all that matters right now. Let's see. Oh, almost sniped her. She can't get that synergy. She got me? How? God damn it. Okay. I'm definitely glad I shielded right there. I'm definitely glad I shielded right there. Knew you would drop the shield right there. Alright. Hey, that's how it works. Did I get her? Yeah, of course I did. That was really good. That's really well timed. I think because of the reduced speed from Rotom, maybe she can act out fast enough. There we go. There we go. All you have to do is zone them out with the freaking aura charges, and you're good. So even I honestly feel like if you're playing a set with someone and you lose the first game, it can really like dishearten you. And be like, oh no, I lost the first game. I have to win two games in a row. Like you have a mountain to climb at that point. But as you can see, it's possible. I mean, you could do it. I feel like if you're playing someone in person, it's even harder. You'll win next time. Okay, sure. Because if you're playing someone in person, they're all set up, they're all like, yeah, I just beat him on the first round. All I have to do is win one more game now, and I'm good. So they're feeling confident, you're feeling disheartened, and it's like, oh God, how am I going to win this next game? You can do it. Trust your instincts. Okay, so I have a Charizard. I'm going to flip tables. Flip the tables. Okay. Okay. We in Diggersby Land again? We in Diggersby Land again? You're right. Okay. I always get with my gut. Okay. Run at me, bro. Oh my God, okay. Oh, I'm dead. That's a free combo. That's another one. His shield is so red though. I'm pretty sure I count this. Okay. Fucked up that combo as well, that's not good. I'm pretty sure I counted. Okay, so I need to practice those. For some reason, I'm messing up my counter cancel. I thought I had like a... Oh, okay, that's why. I was pushing it wrong. I'm messing that up now, I don't know why. Damn, oh my God. Ah, miss me. Oh my, jeez. Oh, I just used my counter. Ah, dead. Oh my God, okay. Get out of here. I'm dead. Get out of here. Did I do it? Oh, I thought I comboed in from Rotom's Rotom Shock, that would have been sick. Oh, that was close. I spun him up in the air with Rotom, and then, like, as he came back down, I tried to synergy into it, but I missed. I did it too late. It would have been sick if I landed it. So I almost got 5 and everything, almost. My defense technique and bonus. Awesome. Whew, okay.
That was awesome.
Eito. Eito with the Blaziken. This is our last match. We picked ourselves back up. We're doing super well now. Knock on wood. All right. I think this will put us, where do we go? We went from 90 to 74. So this will put us, we went up 26 ranks. No, we're up 16 ranks. So I'll put us, the next one should put us in like 58. If we win this one as well. If.
Go show them what you're made of.
It's the last one we have to do. Ooh, only just. Damn, son. That was cool. Got your shield, man. Nice. Nice. Wait. Bam. Ugh. This is some strategic play. Like, I'm actually responding to, like, his movements and stuff, and then making decisions based off that. I don't know if you're catching that at all. I actually think jumping when using Aura Sphere is bad. Oh, I dropped my shield. Get down from there. Get down from there. Ooh, I charged it a little bit as well. If he grabbed me then. Alright, watch this. I'm gonna pull this out. Wait, hold up. I honestly felt like... What? Yo, this is crazy. Lucario Blaziken matches are insane. That was sick. Like, we clashed like 4 or 5 times right there. That was absolutely ridiculous. Blaziken and Lucario matchups are insane. That's so much fun. Yo, that hitting on the background is kind of creepy though. I almost had like full 5 in that. That was the closest I've been, I think. 5-star battle count.
You earned a new title.
Was that 5-star? I didn't quite get to see. Alright, so like I said, it was a 58, did I say? Oh, and it took us to 60. So I guess the higher you go, the slower the acceleration is to the top. So we've conquered 20 ranks now. We were at 90, weren't we? So we've conquered 30 ranks. And obviously it gets slower as we go along. So I think we'll probably have to go through that another 4 or 5 times before we can get to top 8. But I think I'm gonna end this episode off right here. If you guys have enjoyed this Pokemon Tournament episode, then please do slap a like on it. It's super, super awesome of you if you did. Thank you so much. But with that being said, I'm gonna catch you guys in the next episode.